Thanks for joining us on the Bullet Points. Today we're going to be going over a flashlight from a company that's new to us. Name is Thrunite, Thrunite. This here is the TN11S. This one runs for anywhere from a little over 9 lumens to 830 lumens. And also the working voltage on this thing is anywhere between 3 and 12 volts, and we'll go into that a little bit later. The TN11S, as well as the majority of the Thrunite flashlights, they have a Type 3 hard anodizing finish, so it's scratch resistant. It's still going to scratch up like your Surefire will or your Nightcore or whatever, but it's going to be, you know, obviously resistant to it. It cleans up real nice. Certain things will just wipe right off. It's got a stainless steel front striking bezel here, so you can actually break some glass with it, or you know, if you're definitely in an emergency and you're being attacked or whatever, you can definitely hurt someone. So there's a couple cool things that come with this flashlight. I'm gonna go ahead and grab the box real quick. Opening up the box that this comes with, you're gonna see it comes with a little carry case. It's got a little belt loop here. You can put it, you know, hook it onto your belt. It actually comes with a pretty nice lanyard. Some of the other flashlights, like the Nightcores, they come with a kind of a little chintzy lanyard. This one seems pretty rugged. And then also it comes with this Thrunite little user manual. It tells you a little bit about the flashlight and how to, you know, turn it on and off, different modes and all that. Okay, so actually diving into the flashlight itself. All right, so if you take a close look in here, I don't know if you can see it or not, but there is one emitter in here. It's a Cree XMLU2 LED. So this one's got about a 20-year lifespan to it. Nobody keeps a flashlight for 20 years, but this thing's not, the LED's not gonna, it's not gonna die on you. The on-off switch is on the tail cap. So it's gonna start off in the low mode, and then your mode adjuster is in, or your mode selector is on the side of the tail cap right here. So it's your low, your medium, and that's your bright right there. And then also there's a strobe. What you can do is to activate the strobe, there's a couple different ways to do it. You can hold down the mode button and then it's continuously on. Or if the flashlight's off, you can just touch the side button here, the mode button. You hold that down, and it's just a momentary strobe for as long as you have it down. So, another cool thing about this flashlight is that this thing runs off of either CR123 batteries, so it's gonna take two CR123s or one of the 18650s. Right now we have an 18650 in here. So with the one 18650 battery in here, we were testing out the brightness of it. The brightness actually seemed similar to about a 500 lumen flashlight that we were comparing it with on the max, or on the highest setting. So the cool thing here though is this thing's actually rated at 830 lumens. So what you're doing here is you can do three, there's a little attachment here to add on, you can do three CR123s, you can do four CR123s, or you can do two of the 18650s. So actually using four of the CR123 batteries or two of the 18650s is actually gonna give you the lumens that it says that this thing has. Another really cool feature about this flashlight is that, I'm gonna put in the two 18650 batteries, but this has reverse polarity protection. So as you can see, I'm an idiot and I'm putting these in backwards. Turn it on, obviously it's not gonna work, but it's not gonna damage the flashlight like most other ones will. All right, so let's go ahead and put these in the right way. And I'll show you how bright this thing really is. And we'll be taking this thing outside to show you how it is in the real world. All right, so that is pretty bright. So actually I can feel the heat from it here. So that's the low, it's the medium, and that's the 830 lumens right there. And also you have your strobe that goes off of the 830 lumens, and that is pretty devastating. Another notable feature about this flashlight is that it is weapons mountable. So if you want to get a little 1-inch attachment here to, so you can put it onto your rifle or whatever, and through night at their store online, they sell a pressure switch that you can put on the tail cap here, or exchange the tail cap with the pressure switch, and put it on your AR or whatever. A couple other things about this flashlight is that it has kind of a little anti-roll device here, if you want to call it that. So if you have it on the table, it's kind of going to stay in place a little bit if you're on a little bit of a slant. And then also it's IXP8 rated, so it is somewhat waterproof. It's actually a pretty cool flashlight. It feels nice. It's not too heavy, but it does feel sturdy. So all in all, this is actually a pretty cool flashlight. You know, it's got a nice sturdy feel to it. We're gonna be doing some more testing on it out in the open, so you guys can kind of see how that works out. You know, we picked this thing up for under $50. So you can find it on Amazon, or we'll post the link to Through Night's website below as well. But you know, if you guys like this, go ahead and check them out.